Sinestruck. Thanks to Alina for the request. I love finding out about new shoot 'em ups I'd never heard of, and here's one on the Game Boy Advance called Iridian 2, the sequel to Iridian 3D, which is an okay game in its own right. The visuals are spectacular, but the gameplay is pretty dang limited, even for a shoot 'em up. I mean, there aren't many weapons to choose from, but I guess if you're looking for a very, very basic, straightforward shoot 'em up, then Iridian 3D would have gotten the job done. But the sequel, Iridian 2, also for Game Boy Advance, scaled things down a bit from the 3D gimmick, and while that looked incredible, it didn't lend itself to that great of a game, but here with the graphics scaled down just a bit while still looking amazing, Iridian 2 is a much better shoot-em-up and a lot of fun. The story mode features a total of 15 levels, each with a huge boss battle, and each level is unlocked to play on its own in arcade mode, and each boss is unlocked in a challenge mode. There's 6 weapons to choose from, and it's the usual stuff you'd expect from a shoot-em-up: the plasma laser, the deflector laser, enemy-seeking weapons, particle guns, that sort of stuff, and each one can get upgraded 2 times by collecting these green power-ups. The thing is, you can't select any other weapon other than your default plasma laser until you grab one of these power-ups. After that, then you can enable whatever weapon you want. It's structured a little bit like Gradius in that way. Just move the selection in the upper right to whatever weapon you want using the L and R buttons, and then press B. Or if you need to, you can use your power-up to replenish some health, so that's a nice touch. These power-ups also enable 2 satellites that attach to your ship and add to your firepower. Press the select button and you can lock or unlock them from whatever position you'd like. The game also has charge shots for each weapon, kind of like from the R-Type series, and in addition to that, there's full-screen bombs which are triggered by pressing L and R at the same time, and you can carry up to 3 of them. So yeah, there's a lot to manage here, to say the least. Keeping track of your weapon upgrades, picking which weapon to use for which part of the level or for each boss, knowing when it's the right time to use a full-screen bomb, and you do all that while avoiding enemies and projectiles, and yeah, as you can see, this is some bullet hell stuff going on right here. This game is not easy, to say the least. You do at least have a life meter here, so no one-hit deaths, and there are checkpoints in each level as well. There's 3 difficulty settings. Easy is manageable, but anything above that is a challenge. I have to mention the music as well. It's perfect for this game, and it helps you settle into a zone, so to speak. One really interesting thing involving the music is at the title screen here, there's an audio equalizer that allows you to change the lead, chorus, bass, and drums to the music. I don't know if I've ever seen that on a title screen before. So yeah, the first Iridian game, Iridian 3D, that's more of an exhibition. Like, hey, look what we can make on a portable system. And of course, it's impressive as hell. That goes without saying. But the gameplay was hampered by the visual gimmicks, so once you get past the graphics, the game itself was kind of a slog. Iridian 2 feels like more of a complete game, and hey, even without the 3D gimmick, the game still looks freaking great. I mean, I don't even have to say much, just look at the backgrounds here. But yeah, if you're looking for a straight-ahead shoot-em-up on the Game Boy Advance with lots of weapons and options, some spectacular visuals, and a great soundtrack spread out across 15 levels with tons of huge boss fights, then here you go. The cartridge is usually around $20, so play this one any way you can.